the 5 minute. All right. Move one, pass. Just kidding. That would be a hilarious first move, though. Alright, so I'm going to pick a fight with the stone that's right next to my center. I'm going to pick a fight over there, too. Notice that my group is connected, although he's claimed more territory than I have. Because he's closer to the outside. I'm keeping my group together so I don't make some stupid catastrophic mistake and game over. Well, I see no reason not to cut here. That's kind of slow. He's probably going to react there anyway. Actually, this is his weakest group. These two are a little bit stronger. If I cut here, he goes there. I don't know. Also, I could just claim some territory over here. That's what they tend to call tanuki, when you just play a move out there. Or I could extend toward the corner. I made a couple defects if I do that. I'm not sure. Actually, I could use this to firm up my group, make sure he stays disconnected. No, I just don't know how to play Go. he's confused about why I'm taking so long to think. In my mind, there's a lot to think about. But I think I've done well cutting his group in half, or in three, or however many pieces I want to cut it into. If he goes... Okay. We fight. We're gonna fight all the fights. Okay, I could just take that, but what's the point? I should maybe consider patching my group together, maybe consider cutting, maybe expand out, because we're all really condensed here. I'm not sure. No, killing and taking the corner seems okay, though. So I've got all these defects I've left behind. But I do have the top half of the board, so... There is that. Eeny, meeny, something... This is probably okay. I don't want to place too close to my wall. Although, now he's giving me a little bit more reason to. If I play here, I'm kind of forcing him to push through. It's not my goal. If I go here, he cuts. I cut. Why don't I start with this? I cut. I'm almost dead. Maybe I don't start with that then. Maybe I go here. He connects. I got tons of defects in my shape. Let's connect these three groups. It's actually very bad. I need to block him. So people were asking in this channel earlier, how do you decide where to place your stones? It's tricky. He's got more territory than I do. Do we invade? If I invade here, I can. I don't have any tactics. Okay. I'm gonna try to cut around here. He just has to solidify there, though. So. Life and death problems are fun. If I go there, I've got. He cuts. Or Ataris, I go there. It's still not anywhere near good enough. Oh, I'm just encouraging to push through. If I go there, I don't know if I'm able to get around. Probably not.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
I'm gonna attempt to attack. This is my strongest group, so I'm gonna try to use it.
Four, three, two, one.
So I am an Atari. I'm like in perpetual Atari here. I can't win a Liberty race, or can't win a race around there. I was thinking maybe I go here.
10.
Well, we're gonna try it. So he's got 3 liberties. I've got 2, I've got 1. But I was thinking, because he's got now 4 disconnected groups, maybe I've got something. I'm an Atari here. I feel okay about extending, because I can oh. That's the ladder we were talking about yesterday. There it is. If I go there, he cuts, I go down. I mean, I walked right into a ladder. Walking into ladders hurts.
10, 9, 8, 7.
Oh!
Six,
this was
five,
also walking into a ladder.
Four, 3, 2.
Yeah.
One.
I'm not winning this. Not conventionally speaking. Okay, if I go there, I'm walking into a third ladder. So, let's not do that. So I've sacrificed 3 stones because I walked into 2 ladders. Yeah. First game of the day. It's a good refresher on some of the basics. Basics still apply, even in this circumstance. Do I go into another ladder? okay, we're gonna do something stupid, because I think I'm in trouble anyway. Atari, buddy. Okay, he saw it. Atari again. Oh, I forgot about that. Okay. That's not a good thing to forget about. Well, we're gonna patch the hole, but I'm already down by 8.5 points. Okay, maybe I could kill these two. Nope. Yeah, no, this didn't go well. All right, so obviously walking under ladders is tons and tons and tons and tons of bad luck. Don't do it. If you ignore the tactics of the game, and Go is, you say chess is 99% tactics, Go is also 99% tactics, but it's just there is, there's ways you can think about tactics that don't require you to play out every variation to see what's going on. Yeah. Yep, so. Yeah. Unlike 19 by 19 Go, here there is no Tanuki ever. Tanuki just ain't happening. Yep. So I've seen tons and tons of Go tutorials where the guy, where the instructor emphasizes the idea of Tanuki. That idea concept just rarely applies in a 9x9 game because there's no space in which to Tanuki. Yeah. No, you're right. This is the obvious move. D5 just. Even this is okay. All these things I tried to play later, I should have been playing earlier. Although, walking into the ladder is the wrong way to do it. Yeah, and it's over at this point, so this is where I throw in and we realize that my first 20 moves were pretty bad. And White's got a really solid shape that extends across most of the board. So. Yeah. He says he. What does he say here? He's gonna show. Oh, yeah. So, there's the ladder concept. Is that every time I extend, I get a tarried. So, we see I first place here, white places there, I have to go here, white goes there, I have to go here, and then white just kills the entire group. So, that's the concept of a ladder. So, let's see. How do I. Do I have to go out of full screen mode in order to seek a game? I guess I do. So we're going to try another game. Facing a 25 cube, and we are a 21 cube. So, this means that I'm the favorite in this game. So, basically, I'm gonna try to apply all the stuff that my opponent didn't apply last game. Do I pick a fight? Not where I'm weakest, though. Could extend this way, could. I don't know where I want to go next. Just keep solid, keep together. and just ignore the stone over here. Funny how I lead off saying that, and then this is where we end up. I could fight here. He cuts there. Could go here. If I go there, he has to go this way. Just keep building. I know he can extend his group to three here. Could also play that silly looking move, which really begs for me to play this. Although he goes here, right? And if I go there, he goes here. I could extend downward. Could double Hane, which would be kind of something else. Could go there, and then whichever point he picks, I pick the other one. Kind of like that idea. If I do nothing, he might end up going one of my points, and I have to go to the other. So I should, rather than playing this passive move, I should find something more aggressive. I could go here, forcing that, but what's the point? I don't want to let him connect. Although, regardless what I do, he's going to connect something. I'm just going to play this safe-looking move. And so my territory is the bottom right corner so far. At least this guy understands how important it is to fight. I could start extending into the upper right. I could... I don't know. I do not know. I could pick this. This looks interesting for some reason. He's threatening this. He's threatening that. So now I'm threatening this. And I'm not sure exactly how I follow. He's trying to surround my group. If I go there, he forms a really strong group here. If I go there, he has to connect here. If I go here, he has to extend, and then I try to start surrounding. Seems kind of weird. Actually, this is that same walking under a ladder thing that we've been talking about. It's not yet a ladder. What do I do? Looks like he's got the top half of the board, and I want to cut through somehow. I'm trying to find some way through. Alright. We're going through here. It's bad luck, but, I'm not sure where else to connect. He's already got me surrounded because I played pretty passively this game. So, I'm guessing some way. I don't know. Double honey seems, again, really dangerously stupid. I have to cut him, though. I can't hold back on that threat.
Ten.
No,
nine,
my middle groups.
Eight,
he's Atari
seven,
two of my groups
six,
at once.
Five.
I have to solidify this group.
Five. Four. Three. Two. One.
So I Atari him. I'm fighting him over this lower right corner. Obviously, my fighting technique needs work. But if somehow I can kill this group, then I profit in taking the entire corner. Alright, Yatari's my dude. If I extend, Yatari's me again. So I'm just giving him a free stone there. If I play here, he kills me. I go over there, he kills this group.
Nine, eight, seven, six.
Right. So we have co-threats galore if I continue persisting and being stubborn and dumb. Oh, this is forming some kind of living shape.
10, 9, 8.
I'm gonna contend that it's not living, though. Which is pretty risky. He should not have filled that in. I know he's connecting and trying to become safe and all that, but filling in liberties is not a way to go. I have to connect. Oh, I'm sorry. He connects because that Atari's my stone. But this is really weakened on his part. Do I have to go here?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Five, four.
I'm gonna Atari you here. Oh. I missed that. Okay, second game of the day. I'm dropping four stones and the entire upper right corner because I can't see a two-move combination.
Ten.
I see it now,
nine,
though. He
eight,
just places here.
Seven. Six, five, four, three.
Kind of hard
two,
to do anything about
one,
that. Just gonna concede. Dropping four stones and the entire corner while I've already given this corner and made no effort to fight the other corner is not very good. I tried to type GG, but pop-up dialogue came up and whatever. I need to just pursue one objective instead of pursuing, like, 10 different things at once. I can't play this the same way I play chess. Yeah, it's tricky stuff, because usually I try to just stay in the center and keep solid and keep together. This game, I didn't really care about having central influence, and we saw that my entire group came under jeopardy there. Yeah, I just needed to focus on one idea. That was an early resignation for a low-level game. But I could sense that he's a good player, and I was not winning that. And maybe I could have somehow won it, but at that point it just wasn't worth playing on. Yeah, I did not read this very well. But it all comes down to liberties, and he just had he had enough liberties to make a living shape, and I missed the obvious two-move threat. I obviously needed to play here. Probably having a stone over here somewhere too would help with that kind of fighting. Yeah, so that's wrong. Then because that's wrong, earlier moves have bad motivation. They might be okay in themselves, but they're not well motivated. This is okay. Yeah, I don't know. This doesn't seem very bright on my part. Yeah, I don't know about this. This seems interesting. I expected, yeah, this two, that three. I didn't know what about this. This looks complicated for sure. This is better than what I did, but I think what really I should focus on is having better Aji to begin with. Nah, he's not gonna play that. Oh. Am I really safe down there? I don't know. I'm not good at understanding what's even safe. Like, people talk about life and death problems. I don't even get that far. I'm like, oh, yeah, of course that's fine. Don't worry about it. And my guys are dying way in advance of any kind of life and death situation. There needs to be a subset of problems that's just like, I don't know. It's like the Lee chess puzzles of Go. Yeah, there's tons of reading here for sure, but I don't think my group on bottom's very safe at all. This is not good for a lesson. It's an interesting puzzle for sure, but okay. Gobaduke says 4 is fine. Yeah. This is kind of interesting too. I've seen that shape before. That's complicated. Yeah. So complicated. Well, now if you play this kind of thing, both players are solid enough that life and death problems actually matter. Sumei Go Pro, huh? Yeah, that was interesting. I do want to just play some games and some. I mean, I'm walking into ladders, and until I keep walking under them and losing games, I'm gonna struggle with these. Even, yeah. But I did lose to a 25 Q. I've been saying that I'm probably closer to 30 Q than where I'm currently at with 21, but we'll get there. But yeah, I just need to walk under tons of ladders and things and actually play better moves and stop walking under ladders. Arguably, we could get the 5x5 go board out and solve it. I'm surprised that 7x7's not a thing, though. You would think that for beginners, 7x7 would make some sense. Granted, the game would be quite different from Go itself. But on 9x9, there's just tons of possibility. Oh, just let's see. We got some challenges out there. There's a 21 Q interested in. Maybe my challenge is too fast or something. Whatever. Let's go for a 4 hour game. No, that's too much. I might increase this back to 10, though. So, as much as I want to just play some 5 minute with 30 second Yoyomi, I'm probably gonna have a better chance of finding somebody if I pick 10 with 30. Plus, I might play a little better if I spend more time thinking. I'll take a look for this application. Maybe this is something I could put on my phone. And by this, I mean looking for that Sumei Go Pro thing. Get some estimation of what it actually is. Yeah, I assume that once you get good at Go, 9x9 is really confining. I'm finding that, like, from the lectures I've watched, I don't know. It's funny. Well, I guess this is the point. This is why they have lectures. Fuck. Hmm. Maybe that's too close to a corner. That's actually a really weird shape. I need to think more about that one. So, this looks strongish, this looks strongish, this whole formation looks relatively solid. It's just he controls more space than I do. I'm an Atari, so I need to move. And now he's in a ladder. Okay, he's gone that away. I don't know, just pursue the fight this way? Is this silly? I'm declaring that this guy's already dead. So do I go extend down into his influence? No, I think I just solidify my wall here. Estimate score. So this is just an estimation of what I control and what Black controls. It's estimating that we control the same space-ish. So white to win by 5.5. I don't know what this is about. Cut here. Could extend here. Could keep him away. I'm not sure about this cut. Just seems really weak if I were to cut there. Yeah, I was going to say that estimate seemed... It ignored most of the spaces on the board. It definitely gives an indicator of what's really well controlled, but... although I could mess with the indicator by monkey jumping and stuff. But yeah... Oh, well, I'm an Atari, so I'm gonna connect, but I've been laddered here. If I had more time, I could place 3 stones and be, wait, no, 3 wouldn't be enough to live. That's not good. I've saved these 2. Possibly at the expense of these 2. there's a lot of cutting and fighting and stuff going on, and that should be what you want to do if you're trying to win every game, is actually calculate everything. You don't just want to say, oh yeah, that looks good, let's play it. You want to calculate. I think this is bad for 2 reasons. This is reason 1, this is reason 2. Either way, this group of 4 is doing pretty well now. So, if I go there, he extends, I Atari him, and I get this stone, and I extend downward. If I go here, I'm investing in my own territory, but with the option of killing either this stone or that stone. And this to follow. This is already dead. So this looks like the more convincing way to play it. If I go there, he goes here. I have to. Well, now I can kill this. Yeah, this looks like the way to go. Yeah, the ladder is missing a point. So, when I said I was getting laddered, okay, I was getting forced toward the corner, but he was missing a pretty important point on the ladder, which was the base. You know, so that's how that worked out. Yeah. And the reason he wasn't able to Atari me the whole way is because he had a weak group. Weak group of one stone. So. Let's see. Yep, everything's very cuttable here. Yeah, now if this is your starting position, figuring out where's the best place to put the next stone is a really challenging exercise. In a way, I kind of wish that beginner games started around move 10 or 20, just with a whole bunch of stones already placed on the board, so the beginner doesn't accidentally impale themselves in the opening. Be more interesting to play, just a middle game to end game transition plus the end game itself. This is greedy. Oh my god, that's greedy. I mean, this is pretty damn obvious. He shouldn't be playing in my territory. He wants to live up here, but this is like, he's placed three stones on the edge of the board. Stones on the edge are pretty weak. So I could go there. He would have to extend here. If you go here, he'd have to extend there. Actually, I go here, he goes there. I go here. Oh, my group's weakened. Here, there, here, there, here, there, I get killed. So first, let's deal with the liberty issue of this group. And then we can extend out this way and take the center. Yeah, you're right, it's not even greedy, it's just non-strategic. black is getting sliced into many little pieces. Okay. If I cut here, he has to continue there. That's Atari. If I go here, he does connect his group. Oh, if I go here, though, he has to choose between connecting that and connecting these. But if he connects these, that's Atari forcing me there, and then he connects this. If I do this first, now I'm threatening that. I mean, I've got all kinds of threats here, but... threatening this... And if he extends, I kill this. If he connects here, I can place a stone there. I'm not killing anything. I could also place one here. And just claim the left side of the board. Alright, I'm an Atari. Up-and-comer says that I should hold up. Am I supposed to be taking advice during games? that was the wrong Atari. Yeah, you're right. He should have Atari'd here. I was trying to take the left side. At least taking the left side seemed like a good outcome for me. So this is Atari, he places there, and then this kills his group. So... I mean... is there anything wrong with just killing lots of things? Obviously the way he played it, it's not working out for him. Oh, you're saying I just missed an opportunity. I did consider trying to Atari the two stones, I just didn't see the point. I'm sure there is a purpose to that Atari, I just don't see it. Like, I'm happy when I find a... well, in chess, they'd call it a two-move combination. In Go, I think they'd call it a three-move combination. But I'm happy when I find something that that's more than one move deep. Oh noes, I'm an Atari. Better do something about it. This has got to be the weakest black group I've seen. I mean, these two are something, but everything else is diagonally connected. So I could just play there to firm everything up if I felt threatened somehow. If I felt threatened. My problem here is I have too many good options. This takes time to kill. Well, if I go there, he... Yeah. There's so many weaknesses on this side. This seems like the natural cutting point. I'm struggling to explain why, but this is like where all his weak groups are located. These groups were also really weak, so he strengthened them. So it's like double points if I'm killing stones while gaining territory. But I'm also giving up some territory on the left side if I just keep killing and killing and killing. So I gotta figure out what's the right balance to strike here. Can I punish something, something, something? Like if I go here, I'm very quickly going into Atari. If I go here, who knows? If I go there... Totally not a ladder. Wishes it were a ladder. It's wishful thinking. That kind of forced him to connect here, which is not what I want him to do. So this seems like the most forcing thing I can do. I mean, somehow this also looks tempting, although he just cuts me. No, he can't, because I would kill. That'd be self-Atari. But if I give him time, he's going to solidify all this, and then take the lower right. That's the key point. So that even though this just kills two stones and doesn't itself do very much, black is threatening to do something here if I don't do anything. And I guess once I've got this stone here, I can even build downward and maybe leftward from it. Maybe. Alright, my opponent's finding a move. He's found a move. Now he's actually threatening to cut me here. This would be Atari. This is also Atari. If this, and he goes there, and I Atari again, I'm self-Atarying there. By this, he goes there, I go over here. Am I in Atari anywhere? I don't think so. I found an okay move. Hooray me. Uh Okay, so you see this group of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 stones? Obviously he's counting on, I just play here and he escapes, right? I don't think he counted on this move. Guys, I successfully accidentally laddered an opponent.
10, 9, 8.
So, yay me. Alright, so I'm up by 15, ignoring territory.
7, 6.
Yeah. White wins by 33. What a jerk move would it be if both players passed, and then Black's like, no, actually, all these blue spaces, those are black territory. Actually, that wouldn't be enough to save it at this point. But if you were to, like, mark all the spaces on the board as this is black, 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 and win the game by scoring it just in a way that favors him, that would be an original move. So you're saying that if I had threatened, if I had Atari'd the two stones, somewhere around here, that would have been a really good thing. Something like this, I assume. I mean, this does split up his group, I guess. Not here. Okay. Here? Later on. Here? Maybe here. What did I end up doing here? Oh, maybe here. Whoops, that's a misclick. Let's go back to 23. Oh, I moved 24. Oh, over here. Interesting. Oh, wait. There's something more obvious, isn't there? Although this might be a better way to handle it. Yeah, 3 at 4. Yeah, that just occurred to me at the end of that combination that this is a better way to do it. So I've definitely claimed the center. My group has enough liberties if I'm forced to connect there. Yeah, no, I'm living. And I've got the center space. And he's not able to press me very easily, and I can push him around a bit. Yeah, you say you'd be a little concerned about this group? Or, I'm sorry, about this group. Yeah. Maybe. Or maybe this group. I don't know. Yeah. I actually like the other three too. I like this variation. Because I don't think Black's going to connect there. I think he's just going to give this one stone. And I don't know why. Actually, this seems really slow. This gives White all the territory he ever wanted. I don't know. Well, White's not going to play five there. White doesn't need to take. This isn't checkers. Oh, Black still has to connect the top part. So White's fine then. Okay. So if I were to play this out and just assume these four are dead, White's okay. And White maybe even extends on the left here and tries to reduce this. White's doing fine. Yeah. Huh. Yeah, I think this is possible too. This, in the light of everything we just looked at, this makes more sense. Black's gonna have to connect there eventually. Well, I don't know. I think Black, those four are just dead. I mean, he's not entirely dead, but it's a really sad way to live. Because you get a stone right there. Whatever. Oh, this dies too. Yeah, obviously there's no time immediately for play at E8 here. So you were looking at this earlier. Oh, well, you're right. White eventually plays there, but what's the point? Yeah, no, this is simple. Yeah, some. Oh, wow. Really? I was kind of curious. Just cutting straight down is fine. Yeah, I saw that. There's no way Black's gonna allow this. That's interesting, though. I mean, it's good to see it, but... Yeah. Oh, am I overestimating my liberties? I have to count liberties. Black group has three liberties. There's got to be some way that this works, right? Okay, so I miscounted them. Huh. That's closer than I thought. So, yeah, I guess it is necessary for white to play, to secure that corner before 14 happens. Wait, 9, 10. Let's see, did we already look at 11 at... I'm trying to remember, where were we? Oh, there's this 10 also. Right, and then there's that. It's just barely fast enough. So again, white can't 13 over there. Oh, I'm sorry, 13 there's the best he can do. Yeah. Wait, so... race going on. How about that? No, you're right. Yeah. I think. Yeah. Yeah, Black's just winning that. Okay, so Mu Cao Pong is suggesting... oh! White can Tanuki. Oh! Huh. So in that one line, white can afford to Tanuki. So, wait, we're in agreement that in that particular line, Tanuki's fine. Oh, okay, I get it. So, the conclusion is that once these two... I think. Yeah. Yeah, Black's just winning that. Okay, so Mu Kao Pong is suggesting... Oh! Why can Tanuki... Oh! Huh. So in that one line, White can afford to Tanuki. So, wait, we're in agreement that in that particular line, Tanuki's fine. Oh, okay, I get it. So, the conclusion is that once these two groups connect, that Black would have to, that White's in Ko. That Black would have to surround White and then drop a stone in at the same time. I'm sorry, Ko is maybe the wrong word. Seki, is it? Where this is... It's not a permanent Seki either, because then White's eventually going to come around and kill Black here. It's a, I guess what they call a false Seki, where Black's not able to approach White. If somehow Black managed to approach and managed to place the stone in, then the group should be dead. Shared liberties count for the group which has an eye, because, yeah, that's right. Yeah, it's what they call a false Seki. Because it looks like Seki, because neither player can directly approach each other right on this scene or on that scene. Or this front or that front, but White just approaches from the left here, and Black is done. The motivation of playing 9 at, right here is that I want to prevent an eye shape from forming up here. And because of that, and because Black can't afford to approach, then I can Tanuki, and then maybe also kill this group or something. But Tanuki's pretty useful. But yeah, I played okay. Let's see. Oh, I can navigate this with the keyboard. Nice. Did I do anything interesting here? I don't know. A lot of things fly at a beginner level. I don't like this opening move so much. But fighting has to start somewhere. I should just play some more games and learn some more ideas that way, too. Let's play a game. Oh, it's good to know that C7's also a common follow-up. Yeah, part of the reason I'm taking to Go a little, I had intended to really invest in Shogi. Just really try to learn it really solidly. But it just seems, I don't know, you missed my last time I played Shogi. I think I lost 10 or 15 or 20 games in a row, all against beginner players. It's probably 15, maybe 10. Anyhow, it's just clear that Shogi is very extremely tactical. And if I'm going to invest in that, I have to, I don't know. You really have to gung ho it. You can't half-heartedly start learning Shogi. It's just tons of suffering until you make some progress. All right, so I'm gonna approach a little closer this time. Yeah, well, I'm watching that guy's videos, and those videos don't apply very well to the 9x9 game. And yeah, it's useful for sure. Okay, so the reason I'm getting all these interesting battles is because I keep running away. And if I play something more direct. I don't like when my opponent has stones that are able to exert influence from a distance. I cut. Oh, that would be crazy. Let's look at it this way. Well, I've got a living group. I don't know where my territory is. It's an interesting dilemma. Well, we got some fighting going on, that's for sure. Okay, what are we looking at? Yeah. Yep. So confused. So confused. So if I play here, I'm threatening to. Well, I don't know what I'm threatening. I've got tons of options. I could even Hane here. He goes there. Who knows? I could play this, just flexible. He goes there. I cut. He goes around. I could go up here. Oh my goodness. could go here. He. Okay, this is my weakest group. These are two. He's got three equally weak groups. But I should play next to my weakest group. To strengthen it. But where do I go? I've got this. Got that. I don't know. In beginner games, lots of things fly anyhow. This denies territory, or denies liberties even to these stones. That was amazingly automatic. So I got two liberties, he's got three. So if I try to race, I'm not going to win that race immediately. Actually, if I play here, this kind of increases. No, he goes there. I'm not increasing my liberty count. If I go here, I've increased from one. I've increased a liberty. He's able to decrease my liberties pretty quickly. I don't even know if I have a living shape. Probably not. If I go there, he goes, I go, he kills me, place a stone there, he kills me again. I think this is okay, but if it's not, it's really terrible. I've tried to read it out, and I'm not doing so well with it. I'm pretty sure, though, this is not the way to counter. If I go there, plays here. Okay, at Atari. No, that does Atari both stones, but it also Ataris my own stone. So that's not it. Could go here. I don't know. And go there to Atari a stone. I'm not sure which is better. This one has more liberties than that. Like, if I play here, oh, I've got two liberties for my white stone. This also has two liberties for my stone. I like this somehow. This seems safer than that. Okay, so now he's got three there. So I just, I don't know what I want to do. I could extend. I could cap it off immediately. Extend, he caps me there. So I need to go here. So the big question is, who has a living shape and who doesn't? That's, I'm not sure. I go there, it kills me. I go here, it doesn't quite work. If I go here, I think his group might be escaping if I do that. This looks fun. This looks okay. This looks more fun. This looks way more fun. Yeah, we're doing this. I'm so confused. Well, this seems like a less deficient shape. This seems, yeah. No, we connect here. Increase the liberties of this entire damn group. Oh, man. He's playing like I would play. That's something else. So, I don't even want to approach this. I just want to let it die on its own, really. If I go there, he goes here. I kill. Yeah, I don't know. I could make a shape in the corner, or I could just do this. Why am I spending so many... Yeah, I should just... take care of this business. No monkeying around.
Ten, nine, eight, seven. Six.
All right, I increase my liberties.
Five, four, three, two, one.
I could kill the group directly, or I could extend and then later come back and kill it. Which seems stupid. I could also just place one here. Yeah, let's just kill. No finesse here. We're on a 9x9 board. No finesse at all.
10.
I might be beating my opponent here. I don't think this group's escaping. Okay. Well, that was my initial thought.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
Alright, I've double Hanade. Mm-hmm. Show me what I've missed. Did I go here? Oh, no, if I keep going this way, I just get laddered, so let's take care of the kill. And then we've got one really big group. Okay, where can I safely place?
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three.
There's a safe move. Yeah, we're still on the 9x9 board. We found another beginner, guys. It's another Atari. Actually, double Atari. Kudos to Black if he can make a living shape down here. I don't believe it. Oh, I should be... Oh my goodness. Nobody's been saying anything about this. This is where I should have been playing the whole time. Let's try it out.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two.
I think I'm okay. I think incorrectly. All right, at least I get your two. Wasn't a total loss. Oh, he passed. Okay, fine. Hooray. Yeah, counting liberties is for close games. I wanted to see if it worked out or not. I won by 37.5 points, so, it was a fun game. I don't know, maybe I offer a rematch. Sure, why not? That was a funny game. So I don't know, like I've seen a few, I've seen, well there's the anime movie, Spirited Away, which is just beautiful. Other than that, one I find kind of interesting is, Detective Conan. Just pretty silly. When am I going on to 13x13? Maybe next time. Yeah, I know, everybody's saying things about Karu no Go, and that's pretty much all they said, is that it's an anime and it has Go in it. Should I watch it? Should we all watch it right now?
No.
I can't do that here. I Am Robert has challenged you to a game. How do I see said challenge? Unranked. Yeah, okay, sure. Why not? How do I turn off the... Okay, here we are. Alright. I've heard that playing in any of the center or nine squares is a good first move. At least for black it is. Feeling this I Am Robert guy kind of knows Go. If he's got the guts to play these kinds of moves early in the game, he's probably got some purpose to what he's doing. I'm playing a lot of really wimpy moves. I'm not going to entirely negate the idea of claiming some territory, but this is a pretty... I don't know. He's claimed a lot more territory than I have. Yeah, if I think he's overplayed, I'm not even sure. Like, I guess this kind of sort of qualifies as a cut, because it keeps these stones separated. That definitely seems even more to qualify as a cut, but... Alright, so I play here... Because, I don't know, I want to try to cut there. Cutting here seems to immediately fail, because he just goes there and connects. Somehow, this seems to attack both the upper group and the left group, I'm not sure. See, if I could just play all the stones at once, I could ladder-ish, maybe. Well, if I play here... I don't know. This still seems like an okay place to go. I'm just gonna go there or something and I get... Oh wait, this is Atari. Let's deal with Ataris. There's the legendary Tiger's Mouth. It can't be too bad. Oh, I guess the other point for my going there is to prevent him from going there. Alright, we're cutting through. This is unwise, guys. I think. Somehow, this way that I'm playing seems unwise, because my supporting stones are not over here. They're over here. I'm an Atari. So we extend. I'm not solid enough to do this, because I just get cut there. Alright, I'm just going to keep running. Just run, run, run. Don't try this at home. Ah, good. Thanks for the warning. Oh, crap. That's not good. Well, gotta connect, right? There goes another stone. Ah, who needs it? But if I could kill all these stones, how great would that be? Okay, what gives? What's he doing? I do not understand. Okay, well, I'm expanding my weakest group. This is the weirdest Go game I've played. How did I get here? Oh, I see. So, my idea of extending is not such a fine idea after all. Noted. Alright, so if I wanted to do that, this would have been a good idea first. Well, there's an Atari. Or even this first would have been okay. Wait. When he played back here. Oh, I'm sorry. He did. Okay. I get it. I didn't miss a chance to just take this. I'm not giving up that opportunity. I think my random moves have confused him. I think that's what this game's come down to, is that my moves are sufficiently weird that he just didn't know how to respond. many liberties. One, two, three liberties. My group has way more than three. I go here, he goes there. I go here, he kills me. Go here, Atari's. I go there. Did I play here? I play here slowing down this battle long enough for me to surround. I don't know if I have time for that. Are you? Oh. Okay. Well, yeah, you're right. I don't even have to kill the group. It's already dead. That's the key. Yeah. Or sometimes you don't have to kill right away, but I think this is one of those cases. Yeah, you said just make sure it doesn't get eyes. I mean, if I play here, I just don't think this is necessary. This is not a living shape here, and it takes tons of tempi for a living shape to form. This is interesting. And he goes there, I cut. But why am I not just cutting here immediately? If I go here, he could Atari me. I'd have to go down. I feel like playing this, I don't understand why. Somehow, just given this combination of these white six stones and this, versus these five black stones, this just seems right. Yeah, well, he's played on the first line too, so it's not terrible for me in this case. But yeah, it's more, it does not help me. Oh, I should have been killing it from this side. I see now. This isn't Othello where I place here, he goes there, and I go back. There's no snap back in this context. So I've made a race of it. That's dumb. Again, I should prevent If you can connect and form an eye, that's gonna suck for me. I mean, I see he connects here, connects there. This would be the eye. Should be denied if I played the corner, but you don't play on the first line. Because that's rule number one, never play on the first line. I know in general it's just a bad idea. I should force the issue a bit, I think. I've definitely complicated my life. But yeah, that move on the first line did nothing. I mean, it certainly trapped him, so he can't connect the group on the left under to the group of the right. But that shouldn't have even crossed my mind in the first place. If I place there, he has to occupy his eye to connect. Oh, if I place here and he connects, and I surround, well, it's important for me to surround in any event. There's nothing worth connecting to. That's what you guys are saying. Thankfully, this is not a ranked game, so it's okay for me to take your guys' advice. But, I mean, my opponent might be ticked, but... So, if I surround... No, I don't want him to form a real eye, though. So I have to press at this point, I think. Part of what is pushing me to make mistakes is the fact that there is any timer whatsoever on this game, and I do have an audience. Yeah. There's a fun video of Don level players watching and commenting on a game that was between 8 cues. Yeah. This is like having grandmasters in chess comment on games between amateur players or worse. And this is day 2 of Go. And look forward to things hopefully improving in the future. But yeah, a blind squirrel finds an acorn once in a while. So, by hook or by crook, I've managed to find some way to win this. Yeah, interesting game. So, yep. I did thankfully let this group go. I don't think I should have extended here in the first place. I'm half tempted to ask him which Atari, but I think he was referring to something much earlier on. So, yeah, this is Atari. Oh, sorry, now I know what he's talking about. That's what he's talking about. This one where he blew it, losing the three stones. Yeah. That was the move he missed. I mean, there's not even a question there that that's... Yeah. You can play a rematch. It'd be fun. So. In my infinite wisdom of Go, I'm not sure where I want to play. Let's knight's move approach this. I want to try to keep things relatively solid, but I'm not sure. So I've finally gotten out of this phase where I'm placing all my stones immediately adjacent to each other. Okay. So now we get some actual fighting. Do I just pick another front just to make things more complicated? Yeah. So I'm going to say this move here, you know what? That's just irrelevant. This is where the real fight occurs. And I connect to my stone. If I go here, that's Atari, he has to connect. What am I doing? This seems... like, this seeing this doubly connected move, this diagonal twice, just seems extremely weak to me. And I'm just questioning, how is this okay? Actually, I've seen a lecture where this kind of move, right there, tends to be the strongest one. Now that's in a global position where there's a ton of open space to worry about. That this was globally optimal. What's locally optimal, I wonder? I mean, if I play here, he connects there, maybe. Or more likely, he just places here, regardless of which of these two I pick. So that's why this is maybe even locally optimal. It's just slow, though. Let's try to connect this... this stone into the fight. Okay, that is Atari. I'm forced to connect my group. It's another Atari. Well, it's not Atari, but... connect it, or failing to connect would just be ridiculous here. I would have to have a very strong move to justify ignoring connecting. Maybe I have such a move. I've got a really bulky shape here. If I cut here... Is this an accidental ladder? I wonder. I cut here. If he connects... Well, I have to cut. I have to see this. Because I don't believe that this is okay at all. I have to see what happens. I go there, he goes here. Just down. Go down, goes over. I'm short on liberties here. I could go here, though. He goes down. I could just try to connect here. Yeah. And this is partly why I'm saying, like, I've got to play it. Ignoring it is just ignoring the problem, allowing it to grow extremely complicated. And I don't want to ignore it for too long. I go here, he cuts, I go, he cuts, I go, I get trapped. Let's just take some more liberty. I'm expanding my weakest group. I've got other weak groups here. You're in the game. What does in the game mean? Either way, yeah, I guess feel free to show these things afterward. If I go... Wait. I'm so confused. So confused. This feels, again, like the right move. Problem is, this is a bi-directional ladder. So I don't want to go too far with it. If it were just a ladder going out to one edge, that'd be okay. But since this ladder involves me getting cut everywhere, I probably don't want to continue this to its logical conclusion on the edge. So instead, I'm going to cut here. The point of this is I'm giving these two stones in a bid to try to win this. Or at least I'm offering them. Yeah. Really, what I need to work on is reading, and that requires patience, especially for somebody who doesn't know, like, what the candidate moves are in these positions. Okay, so he's got four on the edge. Wait, is he winning this race? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Surely I'm winning this race, right? This is a race, and I'm winning it. It just is a little challenging when spectators are like, oh yeah, you should read things out better. And then we get to situations like this one where opponents apparently are making mistakes. This seems like a catastrophic blunder that my opponents played into. If I'm reading this right at all, I play 1, 2, 3, 4, and I collect 5 stones, and I get all the space that the stones used to occupy. Maybe I play this first, and he kills me. So this is a throw-in, but it ensures. I'm not sure what it ensures. No, if he connects this to that one stone, even if this one stone goes all the way around, I just kill the one stone wherever it ends. So I'm pretty sure it's just 1, 2, 3, 4. Pretty sure. I don't know. Either way, so what's the big threat? If I go here, maybe this is a counter threat. Or maybe this, I kill, and I don't know. Like, this group has, this one stone has 3 liberties. This group has 4. So maybe there's some magic where this one stone group gets killed. I place here. He goes there. I do another one. He goes here. So I've gone too far at that point. If I go here, maybe he just goes there directly. But once I start playing in this area, no, I have to go here. He goes there. I can extend upward. So, 1, 2. Oh, I can extend here too. Yeah, 3, 4. And if I have to, 5. Followed by 6, 7, and 8 out here. Well, I'm curious what's going to happen. So, let's see it on the board. He's maybe threatening this also. So if I do this, he goes there, maybe? I don't know. I want to see this play out, and my opponent could play it out better than I can. Okay, so I just did not see that this center group was imperiled. I see. Okay, so there are tons of groups here. I've lost the largest one, obviously. I just can't count. Like, I saw this, and I missed that. This is why I should have first played out here before going into all that. Yeah. That's what complicates this stuff. Yeah. Interesting game. I mean, I commented, I saw this. I just saw this and thought that, like, if he played up here, I would play something down here. I did not think that the center group was threatened. Complicated game. Really interesting. Let's save this one. Yeah, interesting. Yeah, that was good fun. I got another challenge from I Am Robert. Okay. I was gonna say, I didn't think he immediately challenged me again. Right. So, the key point to this entire structure was this point, E6. Yeah, I needed to play E6 before trying to do any of this stuff, because this stuff didn't work. This is a pretty high-level game for somebody like me who doesn't see... Well, I see Atari threats most of the time, but... anything beyond Atari threats, I tend to miss. Yeah, 6, 7. Oh, wow. I imagined things like this. Like, I imagine that if he started getting stones over here, that he would be able to make some sort of eye for himself, and that my attack would be just too slow. Best variation for black. Interesting. Yeah. Yep. Interesting. Apparently I've got fans, guys. Spread the word. People want to see my 30Q play. Or maybe I'm 29Q these days. I don't know. Yeah. Oh, well. Okay. Go's complicated. Often in chess, you just it's obvious who's better and who's not better. Go is just really dynamic like that. Oh, this connects my stuff. Forming connections is kind of important. Huh. I don't know about this F3, G4, H5. Oh, it's safe in this position. Okay. Yeah, I guess my shape is just has no agi whatsoever. Well, no, in chess, I mean, one player has a queen, the other doesn't. Or has a knight, and the other doesn't. At the beginner level. You just count up the pieces, and one guy has more pieces than the other. Go. I mean, even if you've taken some stones, lost some stones, whatever, anything can happen. Although some positions have more potential than others. Well, it looks like I made Robert work for it. He got it. He got the win. I made him think a little bit, though. So, Ray? Oh. But yeah, you remember how I led this game saying that I'm not placing all my stones immediately next to each other? And we got this really interesting game? Yeah. We get these interesting games, and I tend not to understand them at all. Placing stones next to each other will get me somewhere, but... I need to find creative ways to connect them. White plays c7. Yep. Whoever wins that fight wins the game. Yeah, I should continue. It hurts like heck, because all the fans are like, oh, you look at this great thing you missed. Oh, look, you missed this thing too. And I'm going to miss everything. And it's okay. It's funny. Yeah, these are the ones that help you improve, though. Yep, so that's it. I guess maybe I have time for another game. I'm trying to remember what my schedule today was like. Pretty sure I got time for another. All right. Let's play another game. Let's see, I have no notifications. Let's go back to full screen. Oh, in full screen mode, I can't issue challenges. So let's back out of that and play a game. Probably blows the guy's mind that somebody with my ranking has any audience. But people want to see Go. Bam! Center. It's all mine. I declare victory. Let's increase the board size again. I could Atari multiple ways here. Oh, that's self-Atari. Let's not do that. This looks fun. Let's do it. Not there. Okay, sure. I think I'm doing okay. It's basically this one stone I'm trying to keep as far from the actual fight as possible. And I'm trying to keep these groups cut. And not together. Beginners are fun to watch. Like, you have no idea. So I could play here. I think if I play there, he connects, and we have a boring thing. I could go. If I go directly here, he still connects. If I cut here, that's not good. Let's try this. Just try to keep this split up somehow. Oh, yeah. Going into the tiger's mouth, not so good. Connecting, if possible, somewhat better than going into the tiger's mouth. Alright. So look at my beautiful two liberties. Okay. Oh, do I just wheel around and let him circle my center dudes? There's so many races going on here. Capping this seems important. Letting it run, though, I don't know. I get territory. Like, if we just keep running and running and running. Well, now, if I play here, he plays there, I don't escape. I'm trying to keep this some distance from my stones. Yeah, this game, at least one stone somewhere is gonna die. One, two, three, jump. Not the same concept, but we're on a small board, so whatever. Well, I Atari you. Make sure not to get laddered. Let's just keep building the wall. What's the worst that could happen? You build a wall, I build a wall. Maybe you attack my group or something. I don't know. Do I connect here? What's the biggest play on the board? Oh, man. Reading here is tricky. Do I solidify or do I just go for it? Solidifying seems a lot more solid. But I get... This is so much more territory. It's hard to say no. Okay, I'm an Atari. I almost missed that. Okay, that's the worst that could happen, is I'm losing these four. It's actually happening. That's not good. Oh well. Yeah. So I lost four stones. Hopefully I'm getting these. Actually, up there might have been a better way to play this. What's that? I don't get that. Do I just trap that? There's some reason he wanted to play there. Oh, so I could support with this. Okay. If I go there, he goes here. If I go here, he goes somewhere. He's just interested in territory at this point. Alright, we trap you. White can win this. Yeah, okay, so these three were dead in any event. Giving myself some territory. Maybe I should have cut here first to define where the edge is. Oh. Well, this is going to be a game where hindsight is going to be a big factor. Oh, I forgot. Okay, well, that's not so good. It's an appropriate time to resign. If not much earlier. But guys, I got the only space of territory on the board. You see that? That's what the scoring, that's what the score estimator is good for. Yep. Beginners are fun to watch. Because they walk into this stuff. So one thing that would have been nice. All right, what are I play this you win. Oh. Okay. Sure. He's winning all along, guys. You heard it here first. No, that's not what he means. At least I don't think so. It's better than the game, for sure. And people were saying that I had winning chances during the game. Oh. You guys want coordinates back on? We can do that. Here we go. We got coordinates. Looks kind of silly having it on all sides of the board in a 9x9 game, but I like this. It's the optimal play in the situation. Yeah, that I can agree with. I don't agree that it's winning, but it looks optimal. Yeah, obviously I shouldn't have placed this stone down here. Probably there's some nuance earlier in the game that I could have played better. It's definitely asking for fighting this game. I don't know where I should be looking. There's things here, there, and everywhere. I even don't like this. Got some fun moves in this game, but I picked the most unwise battleground. Yeah. Yeah, I tend to overkill dead things. But even this is poor. Why don't I just, like, connect my stones? And try to play just a normal game. Oh. I was really confused about this position, I'll admit. This is a bad shape. Specifically, okay. I guess. I guess the shape where I can be cut either direction is bad. Actually, yeah, what I had been planning was g4 as my next move. And then after g4, I'm doing great. Minus one thing, that g4 is self-Atari. But yeah, I should not allow two cuts. Yeah, what do you do, at least in the 9x9 game where fighting is critical? I should take the time to connect. Okay. Man. Yeah, I guess connectedness is pretty important. Right. Yeah. Yep. It's funny. Well, yeah. It's funny to see all these really advanced things in various lectures and lessons. And these advanced ideas and concepts, I don't know. They don't work so well when all you're supposed to think about is just fighting. Yeah. Yeah. It's good being able to focus on, like, one or two things per game. I mean, some games are really fascinating. And there's a lot to glean from them, a lot of really advanced things to look at. But yeah, just one or two things per game will be helpful here. Let's pick up the pace again. Only because this or the next one might be the last that we have time for. Yeah. There's all kinds of really advanced stuff going on in the games, but getting the basics down first will be helpful. So, I got tired of. I'm gonna take some of these coordinates off. In fact, I find those coordinates really distracting, so I'm gonna remove them again. Sorry. Let's try this. Okay, we've made a little face. Here are the eyes, the nose, the mouth. We're gonna try this. Yeah, reviewing's important, because if you don't review anything, you're not gonna learn. So this is possibly an exception to all that stuff about bad shape, but probably not. I just don't like. I don't like the way the territory is being established here. Okay. I just don't know. Oh, I should have connected straight down. Well. Okay, I've got tons of stones. I just seem really solid here. Despite having no territory. So, I'm threatening various cuts and things. Oh, he's forming a living shape here, isn't he? Oh! Well, that's no good. Okay, I'm being ridiculously impatient, because I just want to see what happens. I just want to throw stones at the board, and, obviously, I've misplayed this. Oh, there's that point that he was talking about earlier, though. in this shape. See, now I actually recognize this thing. I'm in Atari, so I gotta do something. Nothing else I've seen in the successful attacking maneuver that I could use in my own games. Just if my opponent over-concentrates. Threatens this. Well. Triangles are bad. Yeah. That was fun. So. Okay, apparently this is the white attempts to connect under variation. Yeah. Yeah, advanced stuff to be sure, although necessary. Ultimately I'm going to want to understand things like this. Interesting game. Yeah, there's tons of variations. Yeah. Right. Yeah, no. That's obviously best. I guess what I'm learning is that I should not play shots like this. My hope was that, oh yeah, if he tries to surround my group, I just extend and somehow escape. I'm still in this surviving mentality and not accepting what's alive and what's dead. Get another game going. Assuming that's okay with everybody. Yeah. Yeah, counting liberties, it's the first step of not screwing up terribly. Okay, I'm just gonna pick a fight with you immediately. We're gonna do the same damn thing we've been doing this morning, and just keeping ultra super solid, not making any beginner mistakes, and the fans will all be happy. Look at my solidness. Am I not solid enough for you? Ooh, This is over-concentrated already. And it's kind of symmetrical, so it's... Generally, that tends to be bad. But I've split this group from that group. Oh, I'm not close enough to this to pick a fight. Close enough to this one, though. But guys, look, I've not created any holes. I've not made any tactical errors. Just horrible, terrible strategic errors. Okay. Okay, we're taking some chances. Oh no, I lost a stone. Whatever shall I do? How is that move even remotely okay here? I placed too close, didn't I? I mean, I've made a triangle. I might be okay, though, maybe? Ah, the mighty 3-3 invasion. Yeah. Sounds pretty accurate. I should try 3-3 invasions more often. It's got 1, 2, 2, 3 liberties. Okay. I might be losing 20 stones in a few turns. Is that okay? Is it okay if I lose 20 stones? You know, all at the same time.
Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
Oh, never mind, that is a living shape. Okay. Well, I've made a living shape, guys, and completely lost the game, but, living shape. Hooray. Okay, we cut you. I've played way too slowly this game, just in terms of I'm way over-concentrated. Yeah, no, this is busted. This is ultra super busted. Yeah. Empty triangle's a bad thing. I did make a living shape. So, mission accomplished. Let's play another game. Well, is there anything to learn from this? Oh, so my style so far, I've just been picking fights out of the opening as fast as possible. Here I played something a bit more relaxed, and I got over-concentrated. And I did not pursue this very well. Yeah, so, okay, we got a review. We have to do the review, guys. In which I get to hear what we got to see. Well, let's see it again. Oh, there it is. Ew. I mean, I knew I played a bad opening. Oh. I didn't see that until way later. I'm surprised that this early in the game that even exists. I did not see the shape. Completely oblivious to it. Yeah, I mean, this is a play style that's been refuted time and time again. But it's a play style. And until you lose some games, you keep playing it. My first move will be pass. No, I kid. We're not passing on move one. It's kind of funny that it even offers you that option. Okay, I'm super loose now. Which means he's probably going to pick a fight with me. Alright, we got some kind of fighting going. Oh. Alright, best ways to solidify the shape, again, involve empty triangles. The metagame is strong. Yeah, no. Empty triangles are... I've seen many of my empty triangles killed today. They don't control very much territory. No, the empty triangle controls... contains and has potential to contain zero territory. It's like you filled in your own liberties. Okay, connect. Alright, I'm getting cut in multiple places here. I could offer... Oh, wait. Wait, what? What's going on? I'm an Atari, though. I did not even see that. Well, I avoided making empty triangles, but I did not play this right. I'll try to mitigate the disaster, but it's kind of late at this point. If I extend, I'm just helping him gain more territory. I have to patch the holes in my damn wall. So, we're gonna be down... Well... Yeah, down 2 stones on the board. That's self-Atari. Let's connect. So, connecting with my distant stones, like, because I'm not immediately picking a fight every move, connecting is something I have to think more about. Well, this is a plenty miserable position to be in. If I could just get this 1 point back, that would be nice. Oh wait, my failure to play here means I'm getting killed to move faster. Oh, that's not good. Yeah, this is not working. You guys would accuse me of premature resig. Well, I'm down 2 stones. My opponent controls way more territory, maybe. Or at least I've placed more stones in my own territory than he has. His. I'm down to losing 2 more. I don't think I have enough to cover Comey. I don't think I have enough even without Comey. Alright, so now we get to talk reduction. As long as we both keep placing the same number of stones in this space, and if I don't form a living... Oh, I can't form a living group. That'd be crazy. I keep trying, though, because I'm stubborn. Oh, wait. I'm just throwing stones away. Territory is what matters, not this. This is just too optimistic. Way too optimistic. Like, I would have to connect and form living... We have to form 2 eyes in this space. I'm not sure what I'm going for with that move. At least this has some purpose, because I might control a little bit of space here. Go here. I'm confused.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
Does my shape count as living? Can't attack
10,
there.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Is there any way I can control more territory than I've got? I don't think so. Is he threatening this?
10, 9.
I think that's necessary. Okay, so White wins by one more than Comey. I've captured how many? I captured none. He captured 7. Variation. Better to defend with a ladder than to defend as I chose. So, apparently it's more profitable to try to ladder. That makes sense. Yeah, my ladder's not dying, so that's good. Yeah, White's throwing away points there. Although, still had enough to win. Yep. Fun times, eh? 4 Scatmaker. Yeah. I've got time for maybe a quick game. How quick did that go? I don't know. Let's try one more. Might have time for one more here. First play of the game. Oh god. Well, we've got Baz as our opponent. Oh crap, you told me that that was a bad shape. I played it anyway. This is aggressive. This is passive. We're gonna do the more aggressive thing. I'll just connect the shape. Connecting is really slow, though. I've got more stones than you do in this area. Okay, I'm walking into it, guys. I have no idea where my territory is. Well, I mean, how can I not cut this?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh. Shit. Okay. Well. Well, well, well.
10, 9, 8, seven.
Hey, look, I made territory. Woo! Okay. Oh. Well, that's bad. Yeah, I needed to play there. Land here.
Ten, nine, eight.
Yeah, that's GG. Yeah. Yep. That's about what you would expect from a 7Q. Yeah, no, after I played this move, I criticized it and said it definitely should not ever play that. Alright, so what do we got? Okay. I guess if there's no other stones nearby, maybe this is fine, I guess, maybe. But I don't like it. Okay. I guess it's a decent defensive shape. But defense on a 9x9 board's pretty rare. Okay, that makes sense. Yeah. I've definitely seen that shape. Oh, okay. It seems like a very defensive shape. At least here. There's not enough thickness to attack much. Wonder what. I have to get better at calculating that stuff. Although, this is just a good shape to know, I guess. Is that you can let this go, exchange this for that, or exchange this for that. That's good. Yeah, I agree with Mukau. I did not expect my opponent to force me to live. that all said, it's been fun. Unfortunately, real life is calling. So we'll have to continue this some future time. This has been fun. I'm impressed by the way my opponent played this. And yeah, I obviously just don't know any Joseki to the level that my opponent does. Joseki are kind of important here. If you're going to play this wide open stuff, like on this side and on this side, Joseki would be a good thing to know. So I'm kind of afraid to play attacking moves in some circumstances. Like even here, this is pretty defensive. I need to play more aggressively. There aren't any 9x9 Joseki. Everything's just calculation. Oh, okay. I guess that's true. I guess if on a larger, wider board, things can be more predictable. On this board, people just play. because you could play in any one of like 80 locations and your opponent plays in any one of 79, although any is a bit generous. There's probably 5 to 10 candidate moves in any position. Just assume there's 5. Chess has a branching factor of 5 as well, but...
yeah.
Yeah, just calculate right, make good shapes, and fight. And this is not a fighting move. It's not a fighting move. It's too solid, concentrated, and it's interesting that it's a good shape. If that's good for the opponent. Like, if this shape of 2 spaces away is a good shape, obviously you don't want to overdo any one thing, but, this distance seems like a fine thing. Like, I could go here, you could go here, I could go there, you could do this sort of thing. I don't even know how you begin to evaluate that. There's just threats everywhere. And anybody can play just off of one of these locations. Like, you can play here, the black can play there, all kinds of variations. So, yeah, there's stuff to figure out, but in any event, real life does call. So I'll have to cut it short here. So I guess thanks for stopping by, and we'll continue this again sometime. So I'll see you around.